I'd like you to imagine you're Kelly. Kelly is a 34-year-old lady who wakes up and struggles to hold a kettle and has to ask her 7-year-old daughter to tie her laces before setting off to work. Why? Because she has rheumatoid arthritis with worsening pain and swelling in her joints despite the current best treatment. If left untreated, like many others, her lifespan will be reduced by 3 decades. She will soon give up employment and will remain dependent on others. So what's the problem? Well, the very immune system which defends us against infections such as coronavirus and the flu can turn on itself and attack one's body, resulting in autoimmune disease. Kelly's situation is not uncommon, and autoimmune conditions like rheumatoid arthritis affects 500,000 people in the UK in the prime of their lives. Young people are devastated by the impact of their disease, which can affect vital organs, including the kidneys and the lungs, and pose a risk of premature death and significantly affecting mental health. So how does this happen? Well, if you look at figure 1 of the slide, you can see Kelly's hand, which has areas which are red and inflamed. These sites of inflammation are like crime scenes. And who are the partners in crime? They are the specialized cells of the immune system, which are called B and T cells. In these crime scenes, the criminals, the B and T cells, closely cooperate and network and cause inflammation in the joints, rendering people like Kelly unable to care for herself. Unfortunately, current treatments can be non-specific and don't target or clear up the full crime scene. So what's our solution? Well, in my project, I'm investigating a new antibody drug, as in figure 2, called a TCB. And this stands for T-cell Bispecific Antibody. Usually, an antibody binds to a single specific target, but these are engineered to bind 2 different cells, and in our case, the specialized B and T cell partners in crime, and these are handcuffed by the TCB and turned against each other. The aim of this treatment is to disrupt the immune networking that you can see in the first figure and reduce inflammation, as shown in figure 3, where the function of the hand is restored and Kelly's pain has improved. I have obtained blood samples from the patients with autoimmune disease and shown that this new treatment works in the laboratory to disrupt the B and T cell network. We also have insights into identifying who will benefit most from this drug and when is the right time to use it. This brings home personalized medicine. So to conclude, we hope that this novel treatment approach will help people like Kelly to lead longer and healthier lives, as well as regain their independence and be free from pain to better care for themselves and their loved ones. We are so excited that we can engage with the pharmaceutical industry to bring this therapy into the clinic. We hope, therefore, that our TCB will trick the T cells to attack the bad disease-causing B cells, and thereby, as in the title of my slide, coerce cellular cooperation into conflict. And that's why it's a paradigm shift in treating autoimmune disease for young people like Kelly. Thank you.